dear learners, today in this class, we are going to discuss about two different tools that the teacher can adopt in the class. The first tool that we are going to discuss here is about the checklist. The behavior of the students differs in different situations. The teacher's observation and record of the behavior of a particular student plays an important role in evaluation procedure. Checklist, therefore, is a tool which helps the teacher to record the student's performance in specific activities. Checklists usually contain list of behaviors, characteristics that are either present or absent in the person. Here, my dear learner, today I have brought for you a diagram of a checklist, and I have prepared it on the performance of performing geometrical construction, which I am going to show you here. Take a look at this chart. In this checklist, as I already told you, that I have adopted a theme which is on performing geometrical construction by the students. Here, all the activities related to the performing of geometrical construction will be noted down by the teacher. And on the right side, the teacher will leave space for giving or putting tick mark by the students if yes or no, or if they have done correctly. This is depending on the subject that I have taken. So, here in this checklist, I have put collection of acquired instruments, then taking a piece of white paper, with if the teacher has done or not, it will be given a tick mark here or a cross mark. Then sharpening of the pencil, then correct use of the instruments, then performing construction stepwise, then numbering of the geometrical figures, and then lastly any other if there is any. So, teacher will put the tick mark here, or teacher will adopt this checklist in order to see the performance of the students. The checklist enables to know the presence of an event, behavior, characteristics of a student by marking tick mark in the column meant for the behavior trait. After filling the checklist, you can use it for planning and modification of your strategy, facilitating for better learning. The particular checklist also allows the teacher to check the skills in which the student needs further training, characteristics of students' behavior. If you are using such a checklist for observing group behavior, then you have to look for the activities of the majority of numbers of groups and try to note the behavior of the deviants along with the observed behavior included in your checklist. The checklist is useful for you in a variety of ways. These can be adopted for a number of purposes according to the need of the students or the teachers and the class. Learning outcomes, which involves process and personal social development, can be easily evaluated by recording evidences of growth in respect of specific learning outcomes. In evaluating the process, which can be divided into a series of clarify, define, distinct and specific actions, checklists are most useful. Checklist is also very easy to prepare and simple to use. Let us now go into the rating scale. Sometimes you may be facing some queries about the performance of your students from different quarters. The parent may be asking, is my child showing interest in games? Does she dance well? What about the overall performance of my son in science? The headmaster might be inquiring, are you satisfied in the cleanliness habits of students in your class? How was the Sunita's exhibits in the inter-school science exhibition appreciated by the visitors, and so on? How do you reply in such queries? Usually, our responses are in very qualitative terms like just average, excellent, above average, satisfactory, etc. In other words, we are rating the attributes in a scale ranging from extremely negative level, poor or unsatisfactory, to extremely high level, excellent or highly satisfactory, etc. In brief, we are rating the performances or attributes in a rating scale without being much aware of it. A rating scale is an instrument that requires rather to assign the rated objective that has numerals assigned to them. Rating scales resembles checklist, but it is not a checklist. It is to be used when finer descriptions are needed. In checklist, what do? You merely indicate the presence or absence of a characteristics through a checklist. But in the rating scale, you have to indicate the status or level of quality of what is being rated. This is the second chart that I have prepared for you today. Now, what differences do you observe between this chart and the previous chart? In which way a rating scale is different from a checklist, which gives you more qualitative description of students' behavior? Well, this rating scale is prepared under the 5-point scales, 5 representing the outstanding, 4 representing the above average, 3 representing average, and 2 representing below average, and 1 representing unsatisfactory nature or behavior. Today, for your convenience, I have prepared a rating scale on participation of a student in the classroom activities. Here, for observation of their participation in the classroom activities or the school activities, I have given certain instructions to the one who is going to use this rating scale. So, under this instruction, I have written, please encircle the number on the right of each question indicating the level of active involvement of the students as per your observation and judgment. This the reader will understand that under this category, the observer has to rate the students' activities. Accordingly, few activities I have mentioned here. For example, the student is active in class projects, following which I have given these 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 rates. You can also use a 3-point scale also. Second statement suggests that the student relates to his peers. Third is the student participates in group discussion. Fourth, the student is active in sports activities. The student is active in club activities. So, out of these 4 activities, one will rate them in the form of 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, which are representing all this accordingly. So, this way a student's performance and student's activeness in the school activities can be judged and can be rated through a rating scale. The qualitative descriptions can be quantified by encircling the appropriate number of satisfying the emphasis given by the cater on the behavior of the students. That's it for today. Thank you very much.